Welcome back to PSL Living. I'm Sarah Prohaska, Public Information Officer for the City of Port St. Lucie. August is Muscular Dystrophy Awareness Month, and you may notice some buildings, including right here at City Hall, lit up green. And I have Nadine Kirby, the founder of Light It Up Green, joining me today here in the studio to tell us about this effort and what this month means. Nadine, thank you for joining us. I really appreciate it.
You're welcome. I thank you for the amazing opportunity and thank Port St. Lucie City Hall and the people of Port St. Lucie for being so gracious, especially the mayor for granting Muscular Dystrophy Awareness Month proclamation.
Okay.
And for not only the proclamation, but for lighting as well.
We've got City Hall lit up green. Mm-hmm. For Muscular Dystrophy Awareness right. Month after you presented this idea to us. We said, that's a great idea.
You took it and ran with it, which was really awesome. And I really appreciate it, and I can't say thank you enough. We have some amazing things going on throughout the country. Uh-huh. There are over 62 lightings of landmarks and buildings and bridges, you name it. We've got it lit, and it's lit green for muscular dystrophy, but mm-hmm. When we say muscular dystrophy, sometimes it implies that muscular dystrophy is one thing. Mm-hmm. We're actually lighting for 52 neuromuscular diseases.
Okay.
That being said, when we talk about muscular dystrophy, I think a lot of times, because my son has one type, mm-hmm. which is Duchenne, we tend to think that it's one thing, and it's really 52 neuromuscular diseases. That includes ALS, mm-hmm. which is Lou Gehrig's disease.
Yes.
Duchenne, which is another well-known, and SMA, which is spinal muscular atrophy.
Okay.
And I know many, many families, which is what inspired me to start mm-hmm. the Light It Up Green campaign.
And you started Light It Up Green 4 years ago?
I started it in 2014.
Okay, 2014.
I started with nothing more than an idea.
Okay.
And I decided that I wanted to do something big, something that was going to grab the attention, mm-hmm. and something that was going to shine a spotlight on not only the muscular dystrophies, but also the MDA, which is the Muscular Dystrophy Association.
Okay.
National organization, uh-huh. a national nonprofit organization that I am working with currently. And I've been working with them for 20 years.
Okay.
Because of my son's situation, my son having Duchenne.
Okay.
I've just been super involved, and that's really what inspired me to do the Light It Up Green campaign and to start something so big that it was too big to ignore. So I think it's you know, it's growing and growing, and it's amazing.
And you said you started in 2014, and that year you didn't have any buildings lit up. You started working.
I started with proclamations.
Okay.
Which are, you go to each individual state through the governor's uh-huh. website, and you mm-hmm. apply.
Yeah.
And basically, you send them all the information, and you send them the text language and what it's supposed to say. And I don't even have a sample
with me.
But you apply, mm-hmm. and you know, hopefully by the grace of God, they give it to you.
Mm-hmm.
2014, we had four states.
Okay.
And we had nothing else. 2015, I moved on to 46 states.
Oh, wow.
And with five lightings.
Okay.
And then 2016, we moved into 16 lightings and 47 states.
Okay.
This year, what we have now is 49 states and 6 cities that have declared August as Muscular Dystrophy Awareness Month, and also Light It Up Green for MD Month, because I wanted to tie the two together at some point.
Okay.
And it's been amazing. It's just...
How many buildings are on your list here?
Approximately 62.
Wow. And these are some pretty big mm-hmm. landmark buildings across the country.
Yes.
The New Orleans Superdome, the Wrigley Building in Chicago, mm-hmm. You know, California's U.S. Bank Tower. Mm-hmm. So we have some, you managed to get this all over into some really big places.
Well, the whole thing is volunteer. Uh-huh. Light Up Green is a campaign, okay. so I do this on my own.
Yes.
I have another friend of mine that lives in New York. Her name's Tina D. Gregorio, mm-hmm. and Tina is amazing. She's my duplicate.
Okay.
She has gone to every city and every state and everything we could think of and asked to light. We have a specific lighting letter that we send out, mm-hmm. and to our surprise, a lot of people came back with, yes, the Peace Bridge was the first one.
Okay.
The Peace Bridge is the most magnificent bridge. And
where is
it
that?
It goes from the U.S. to Canada,
Oh, okay.
The Peace Bridge.
Okay.
So it's amazing. We do have some lightings actually in Canada.
Okay.
We have in Vancouver, we have the BC Place Stadium,
mm-hmm.
which is ginormous. I have pictures of it. It's
mm-hmm.
amazing. We have the Edmonton Bridge. It's the high-level bridge in Edmonton.
You've really spread this to some really well-known places.
You know, and I hope to continue to do
mm-hmm.
so, and I'm not giving up yet. I'm still working on a national proclamation to be signed by a president.
Okay.
If not this president, I've been working on it
yeah.
for a couple years.
Okay.
I did receive a letter from President Obama that thanked me for
mm-hmm.
Spreading awareness and for doing this campaign and making communities aware,
yeah.
which was fantastic, but I still want the proclamation.
Yeah, exactly.
I still want that national one signed. It's very important.
Yeah, and this is something you do in your spare time. This
mm-hmm.
is all voluntary,
mm-hmm.
and you got mm-hmm. into this, like you said, because your son has Duchenne.
Yes.
And he was diagnosed when he was three?
He was diagnosed when he was three and a half.
Uh-huh.
We became family members, MDA family members. We registered with Muscular
mm-hmm.
Dystrophy Association right away, which they're an amazing organization and guided us and
mm-hmm.
showed us different things. And of course, we learned things on our own and we're
yeah.
able to now.
Uh-huh.
My son is going to be 24.
Okay.
So living with Duchenne muscular dystrophy to this age is rare.
Uh-huh.
I do know some individuals that are living into their 30s.
Okay.
But most of our kids do not.
Okay.
And it was really, really important to me to get that out there
mm-hmm.
and for people to understand all the different types of neuromuscular diseases, because
mm-hmm.
there's 52, but there's subset groups within them, and then there's combinations.
Oh, my
so
goodness.
It's really,
yeah.
I don't even want to get into a whole scientific
mm-hmm.
episode
yeah.
here, but yeah, it's really important to get the word out there and spreading the word. The color green actually represents Duchenne.
Okay.
But I thought it's a beautiful color,
uh-huh.
as you can see, the
yeah,
color.
We lit up our studio
Thank
green
you.
Today. Yeah.
As you can see, you know, the color green is very pleasant.
Mm-hmm.
It's very calming.
Mm-hmm.
But it's also very bright.
Mm-hmm.
And it illuminates the most gorgeous buildings in the world, in the country. I mean,
yeah.
I'm hoping to light the world. That
yeah.
would be wonderful.
Yeah.
Eventually we'll get there.
You will, I'm
yes.
sure. All right.
Mm-hmm.
So, what should people know? Like, what's one of the main messages you're trying to get out with this?
Well, that muscular dystrophies are not rare, that there
mm-hmm.
are people living in communities all over the country and all
mm-hmm.
over the world with the different types of neuromuscular diseases.
Mm-hmm.
Just, you know what? They want to be just like everybody else. My
mm-hmm.
son wants to, is just like
yeah.
everybody else.
Uh-huh.
They are just like everybody else.
Yeah.
But it's important to highlight the health aspect,
mm-hmm.
to get the word out there more, because more and more we're seeing our children live longer.
Yeah.
And unfortunately, you know, they're going to visit hospitals and
mm-hmm.
they're going to visit this and that, but it's important for people to be aware and to know exactly what it is and what they're dealing with.
Okay.
So, I mean, and not only that, the Muscular Dystrophy Association does amazing work. They provide clinic throughout the country.
Mm-hmm.
Their presence is throughout the world.
Mm-hmm.
They do summer camp for kids 6 to 17 years old, which is an amazing summer camp.
Yeah.
They have them all over the country.
Great.
What else? They do so
yeah.
much. And research.
Okay.
Research is really, really, really imperative. We've come so far
mm-hmm.
with research. In the last year, we have discovered, or the scientists have discovered, 4 new treatments for 4 different types of neuromuscular disease. So that's important.
That's awesome. Okay.
That's important.
Yes,
so awareness is going to raise more funds.
More funds.
And
exactly.
funds are going to fund research. And
mm-hmm.
for some, you know, for some of our families, this is imperative that we try to find a cure and find viable treatments.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So really, that's...
That's why you're doing it.
Yeah, that's
yeah.
why I'm doing
mm-hmm.
it, because it's so important.
Yeah.
You know, I mean, my son, like I said, because of the care that he's
mm-hmm.
given and,
mm-hmm.
and we take good care of him, you know, he's still hanging around and he's
yeah.
still here and
yeah.
he's, you know, doing relatively well, thank
okay.
God.
Good.
But it's important.
Yeah,
it's
very.
So important.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Is there a website or someplace
yes.
where people could go if
yes,
to donate
is,
or get more information?
To donate, you can donate through the Light It Up Green campaign.
Okay.
And that is Light It Up Green, the number 4MD.com.
Okay. Okay.
You go there, there's a link, and the link takes you to the MDA My Way page.
Okay.
And the MDA My Way page, I have on there. You can donate through there. It's
mm-hmm.
secure. It's the money goes directly to MDA, which
okay.
is what I want.
Okay.
I want the money to go to MDA. And the other way you can donate is through MDA.org. themselves. And you can actually learn about, through MDA.org, you can actually learn about the different muscular dystrophies that are out there.
And all right.
And, like, and their community presence and just everything.
Okay, great. All right, wonderful. Thank you, Nadine, very much for coming on today. And like I said, City Hall is lit up. So at night, if you're driving by and you're wondering why
is that green? Take some pictures. You can go to Light It Up Green for MD on Facebook.
Oh, great.
You can find me on Twitter at Light It Up Green.
All right. Take some pictures, post it on. I'm sure you'll be happy to, share them.
And tag away.
All right. Thank you, Nadine.
Thank you.
I really appreciate it.
Thank you so much.
No problem.
Thanks.
And we'll be right back after these messages.